Eclampsia in small animals. Eclampsia stems from the Greek word eclampsis, meaning sudden development, referring to the sudden development of hypocalcemia in nursing bitches and queens, as opposed to the hypertension in pregnant women. Hypocalcemia. Hypo meaning low, cals referring to calcium, and emia meaning presence in blood. Low calcium presence in blood. Eclampsia is also known as puerperal, peripartorent, or postpartum hypocalcemia. It is a life-threatening condition that can occur suddenly in otherwise apparently healthy dams. How does this happen? During lactation, calcium is used for the milk that feeds the litter. However, if not enough calcium is taken through the diet or mobilized from the bone, hypocalcemia occurs. Often, it affects small breeds with large litters, usually at peak lactation, 2 to 3 weeks after parturition, or giving birth. Normally, calcium ions binding sodium channels help maintain the normal resting state of the nerve membrane. When these calcium ions are lost, the voltage level required to open the sodium channels decrease. As a result, sodium channels get triggered by even the slightest increase in membrane potential. The nerve fiber here becomes highly excitable, discharging repetitively. With all the motor nerve fibers spontaneously and repetitively triggered, the following clinical signs occur: stiffness, twitching, tremors, muscle spasms, and ataxia. And this can progress to tetany, generalized seizure, which may result to cerebral edema, hyperthermia with all the muscles in constant movement, coma, and death. Going back a bit, although this usually occurs postpartum, post meaning after and partum referring to parturition, mild clinical signs can occur pre or peripartum, before or during, which may appear as slow labor due to ineffective myometrial contractions. Diagnosis. The signalment of a lactating small dog with a large litter is suspect. History and clinical signs should be duly noted. Serum calcium levels less than 7 mg per deciliter in dogs and less than 6 mg per deciliter in cats is confirmatory of hypocalcemia. And prompt response to treatment very much confirms the diagnosis. Treatment. 10% calcium gluconate is slowly administered intravenously. As serum calcium concentrations increase, there is immediate muscle relaxation, and clinical improvement occurs within 15 minutes. The goal is to maintain normal serum calcium concentrations. Management. While the mother is recovering, puppies or kittens should be fed with a milk substitute formula. And if they're mature enough, they should be weaned. Oral calcium supplementation is given for the rest of the nursing period, as well as vitamin D supplementation, to promote calcium absorption from the intestines. Prevention. Recurrence of eclampsia is likely with future pregnancies. Pet owners must feed the appropriate diet during pregnancy and lactation, have water and food available at all times during lactation, assist the nursing of the pups or kittens with a milk substitute formula, and start weaning as early as 3 to 4 weeks of age. Calcium supplementation during pregnancy should not be done, for this may predispose the mother to eclampsia rather than prevent it. This can cause a negative feedback on the secretion of parathyroid hormone, the hormone responsible for increasing serum calcium concentrations. One way it does this is by stimulating bone resorption by osteoclasts. There's a lot of calcium in bone. So, with less parathyroid hormone, when suddenly the demand for calcium is increased as it is diverted towards milk production, the body will be unable to mobilize its calcium stores in order to meet that demand. And serum calcium concentration decreases dramatically, resulting in eclampsia. So, don't do that during pregnancy. To summarize, eclampsia is a sudden, life-threatening hypocalcemic episode in nursing dams. It occurs when there is not much calcium to sustain milk production. In the absence of calcium, nerve fibers become highly excitable, leading to signs such as tetany, seizures, coma, and death. Prompt response to treatment with calcium gluconate is diagnostic. Treatment is aimed at keeping serum calcium concentrations within the reference range. Calcium supplementation may be given to manage eclampsia during lactation, not during pregnancy.